Alright, wanted to show you guys this LS block before we get machining on it. This has already obviously been disassembled, all the bearings stripped out of it. It has been baked and blasted to make it look new. This is what it looks like raw before the machining processes that you will see shortly. Give you just a quick overview of this thing. You can see it looks, the bake and blast processes does a pretty good job of making this thing look pretty much brand new. This has got like a, I think this is 130,000 mile engine block, so tell it looks pretty good. So I'm gonna get this thing set up and we're gonna deck it. That's the first part of our procedures, and then we'll move on from there. All right, just wanted to walk through this with you. I got the block up here. I still have to put the dial indicator on it and square the deck. This bar goes through the mains. I don't know how familiar you guys are. This is a kind of a older decking machine. It is a Blockmaster 85B by Strom Vulcan. So what this allows me to do is I put an indicator up here down, or from the cutter head, from the cutting head here, to the bar and run it along the bar, and that ensures me that the bar is level. So by that, I can then ensure that the deck, if there's variance from end to end, that we know that that is true variance from it being square to the crankshaft. It is not square to the crank if there is variance there. So once I get it to this point where it's on the bar, I roll the block this way or that way to just adjust that axis, and then we cut it from there. So I'll walk you through that real quick. I'm gonna get the indicator up here. See too, I'm gonna spray a little bit of oil on the deck and hit it basically with a board with some sandpaper on it just to see if there's any super high imperfections that I can avoid with the dial indicator when setting the other axis there. So I'm gonna keep working on it. Try to give you guys a view after the first cut. I pulled about a thou off of it. You can see the surface that's been machined and the surface that hasn't. You can see the twist in the block as it transitions. See that? From where it was touching to where it wasn't. This had 4 thou worth of rise in the back of it. So this was 4 thou higher. That's why this surface is all cleaned up. And it had 2 thou of twist. This corner was 2 thousandths low. Here, and you see how that fades into here. I know it's kind of hard to see, but give you an idea. So I'm going to keep making passes with this thing. Like I said, I think that was 1 thou or 2 thou from the low point from there. So I'm going to keep making passes here until it's all cleaned up, and then I'll show you what it looks like when it's finished. So here's the one side finished up. It took 6 thousandths to get it clean. You can see it looks good and consistent everywhere now. So I'm gonna roll the block over and cut the other side to the same 6 thou. Hopefully it will clean up in that same distance. If it doesn't and I have to cut it significantly more, say 7 or 8 or 9 thou, then I will have to come back to this bank and make sure they're both the same. So We're gonna roll it over, set it up, and I'm just gonna breeze right through that and cut it and show you when it's finished. It took 7 thou to clean this side up, as opposed to the 6 on the other side, which for this this specific application is plenty acceptable. So I'm gonna get this thing off of here and stick it in the hone and get rid of the size of the cylinders. I think we're gonna go, this thing doesn't have much wear in the cylinder wall, so I'm just gonna start with some coarse stones. We're probably gonna go 10 over with it. I'm going to mic it first just to confirm that, so make sure we don't actually have to put it under the boring bar and cut the cylinders, but if we've only got to go 10, I can do that in the hone just fine. So I'm going to get it off of here and mic some cylinders up and stick it in the hone. I'll give you one more shot of this before we stick it in the hone. I mic'd the cylinders. What I'm looking for there is the biggest one, and to determine if I need to bore it or if we can just go into the hone. These more modern ring packs, the cylinders don't wear like you're familiar with your old 564s or 16ths ring grooves that the older engines came with. These things, for example, this thing had 130-140k on it. The worst cylinder is 3 thou big at the top and 1 thou big down in the bore. So honing this thing 10 thou is very achievable and is currently my plan. So I'm gonna get this set up in the hone and the torque plates on it, and I'll walk you through that as well.